This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
Amen. Chazak u'baruch. Chazak u'baruch to Harav HaGadol, the greatest mezakeh harabim, Harav Ilan Meirov. You should know that saving one soul, one neshama of a child, it's olam maleh, like saving the whole world. And Baruch Hashem, Chazak have saved by now over 530 kids. I was by the office of Chazak last week, and I saw the number. It was 529 last week. Maybe it's 530 now.
Okay. Los Angeles, it's in Oshawa.
Los Angeles, another one. So 530. Baruch Hashem, this is just the beginning. This is the beginning of the revolution. Our goal is not to leave even one soul behind. We want everyone back to the sources, back to the Shorashim. All the Jewish kids should be learning in Jewish yeshivot. This is the goal, Be'ezrat Hashem. There are 9,000 learning in public school. Be'ezrat Hashem, my wish is that the public school will carry a big sign on the top, Yeshiva of the Yeshiva of Forest Hills. That's good also. That's just the beginning. Today we're going to speak about Ma'asrot. Ma'aser Ksefim and Ma'asrot in general. We'll start from the Pasuk in the Torah. The Torah says, Aser te'aser et kol tivu'at zar'echa ha'yotze ha'sadeh shana shana. You should do Ma'aser from all the harvest that comes on your field every year, year by year. It's known that mitzvah of the Torah is, if a person has a field in Eretz Israel, he should every year take out from the harvest, either it's dagan, tirosh, v'itzhar, as the pasuk says, ma'asar daganecha, tiroshecha, v'itzharecha. Dagan is the grains, tirosh, it's the grapes, the wine, itzhar, it's the olives, the shemen, the oil, that's itzhar. Should take first, terumah gedola, and give it to the Kohen. Min HaTorah, there is no certain amount. There is no amount for the terumah. Afilu hita ahat, poteret et hakeri. He has a whole field full of hitim, full of wheat. He takes one wheat, and he gives it to the Kohen. Terumah gedola, he fulfilled the mitzvah of the Torah. But Chachamim came with the shi'ur. Chachamim said, Ayin benonit, ahad mechamishim. Ayin yafa, ahad me'arba'im, one out of 40. And ayin ra'a, it's a stingy man, he gives one out of 60. He's a bad eye. But the middle midah is ayin benonit, 2%. Ahad me'hamishim, ahad ahuz min ha'hamishim, it's 2%. 2% out of the harvest, he gives to the Kohen, that's called terumah gedola. After it, we do ma'asir. That's called Ma'aser Rishon. We'll take 10% out of the Yevul and we'll give it to the Levi. That's called Ma'aser Rishon. And then afterwards, we take another Ma'aser. That's called Ma'aser Sheni, the second Ma'aser. What do we do with the second Ma'aser? We take it to Yerushalayim and we eat it ourselves. We don't give it to anybody. We don't have to give it to anybody. It's for us. But it must be taken to Yerushalayim. Take it to Yerushalayim and eat it only inside Yerushalayim. And if you have too much, or if you live far away, and you can't carry all the fruits to Jerusalem, so the Torah gives a solution. V'natata b'kesef, v'tzarta ha'kesef b'yadecha, v'alachta l'makom. You can do hilul. You transfer the kedusha of the ma'aser on the money. You take the value of the fruits in money, and you add a fifth extra, Homesh, which means, let's say the value of the fruit is $1,000. You add, how much is 25%? How much is 20% homesh out of 1,000? 200. But that's not the way we are measuring it. It's called homesh milevar, which means we're adding 25%. That together, the 250. If I'll put 250 on top of 1,000, that's going to be 1,250 now. Now dividing 1250 by 5, the 250 is a fifth. It's a homish. That's how we're measuring the homish. So really you should take $1,250 and say, all the kedusha of these fruits that I have here, it's too much, I can't carry it to Yerushalayim, all the kedusha will be transferred into this money. And he takes this money with his hand, and he goes in his hand, and he goes to Yerushalayim. What does he do with the money? He buys food with the money. בבקר ובצון וביין ובשחר ובכל אשר תשאלך נפשך. Any kind of food that he wants, either meat or fruits or any food, as long as he's spending the money for food, on food, he's fulfilling the mitzvah. He eats it in Yerushalayim. That's called Ma'aser Sheni. The Ma'aser Sheni is done only four times in a period of 7 years. Every 7 years we have Shemitah. So we're counting the years for the Shemitah. The first year after the Shemitah and the second year after the Shemitah, we'll do Ma'aser Sheni. We'll take the fruit to Yerushalayim. Also by the fourth and by the fifth year. The Rashi Tevot of this, Aveda, Aleph, Bet, Daled, Hey, these 4 years, we'll do Ma'aser Sheni, we'll take it to Yerushalayim. On the third year and on the sixth year, we're doing, instead of Ma'aser Sheni, we're doing Ma'aser Ani. We take a Ma'aser, 10%, and we give it to the poor people. That's what the Pasuk says. Mikze shalosh shanim, lakachta et ma'aser tevu'aticha, v'inachta b'sha'arecha, uba ha'levi, v'ager, v'ha'etom, v'ha'almana asher b'sha'arecha, v'achilu v'savi'u. This Ma'aser, you give to the ger, yatom, almana, those are the poor people. Uva'alevi, a Levi is the one who takes the first Ma'aser. Ma'aser Rishon goes to the Levi. But the second Ma'aser, instead of taking the fruits to Yerushalayim, you give it to the poor people. So truly, the Torah obligates us to give 10% to the poor people only twice in 7 years. On the third year and on the sixth year. The other years, I don't have an obligation to give 10% out of the harvest to the poor. What do I do with the Ma'aser? I eat it myself. But the Torah wanted me to come close to Hashem. People live far away from Yerushalayim, far away from Beit HaMikdash. They're not getting inspired from Beit HaMikdash. They're not getting from the Kedusha of Beit HaMikdash. They don't get much from the light of Beit HaMikdash. They need to come close. So Hashem wanted us to come close very often to Yerushalayim, to be close to Him by Beit HaMikdash as much as possible. That's the idea. And therefore, the Torah is coming and telling us, bring your fruit to Yerushalayim. There's a lot of fruits. Baruch Hashem, Hashem gave you a beracha. You have tons of fruits. You take it to Yerushalayim. You have to stay there till you finish it. So people really used to invite all the Yerushalmis, all the people from Yerushalayim, please come, join me for the meals. He wants to go back to Haifa. He has a business to run over there. Now he's stuck in Yerushalayim. He has not only ma'aser of the fruits is like this, there is another ma'aser. The Torah says, aser, te'aser, et kol tevu'at zar'echa. Says the Gemara, Masechet Rosh Hashanah, Daf Chet, b'shnei ma'asrot ha'katuv medaber. Ehad ma'asar be'ema, ve'ehad ma'asar dagan. There is another ma'aser to do. Ma'aser from the be'ema. All the newborns from the animals, babakar u'batzon, the newborns every year, you take them into a... You bring them into to a deer, and you're counting them. You're standing, you make a very, very narrow gate, and you let them, you push them out, and you're counting. One, ahat, ahat ve'ahat, ahat u'shtayim, ahat ve'shalot. The tenth one, you mark it. Asiri ye kodesh. The tenth one is kodesh. What do you do with this? Baruch Hashem, Hashem bless you with thousands of newborns, of sheep. So 100... You take 100 sheep now, what do you do with them? You take them to Yerushalayim also. Ma'asar be'ema is also for you to eat. But where? In Yerushalayim. We're saying it in the Mishnah every day. Mishnat ezeh u'mekoman. Mishnah masechet zevachim. What do we say in the end of this perek? Ha'bechor v'ha'ma'aser v'ha'pesach kodeshim kalim. Shechitatan v'chol makom ba'azara. V'daman ta'un matana echat. U'bilvad sheiten k'neged ha'esod. שינה באכילתן. הבכור נאכל לכהנים. The bechor, the firstborn that was coming from the animals, you give it to the kohen. הבכור נאכל לכהנים. והמעשר לכל אדם. Which מעשר we talking about over here? מעשר בהמה. Everyone can eat this מעשר. You just need to take it to Yerushalayim. So now you're stuck. Why are you stuck? Imagine, you have 100 sheep, ma'asar behema. And you have, let's say you filled, produced maybe, let's say 10 tons of grapes. So you take 10%, right? One ton you take. You take one ton to Yerushalayim. That's a lot of grapes now. You have tons of grapes, and you have also olives. You take tons of olives, and you take also from other fruits that you have, from the wheat, and you take everything to Yerushalayim, together with 100 sheep, that's the ma'aser. What should you do now? Eat it in Yerushalayim. And you have to be happy. לא אכלתי ממנו בעוני, בצער, ולא אכלתי ממנו בתמה, ולא נתתי ממנו למת. עשיתי ככל אשר ציוויתני, says Rashi, what's עשיתי ככל אשר ציוויתני? I was happy, I did it בשמחה. So now you're stuck in Yerushalayim for who knows how long. So what do? You're inviting all your friends from Yerushalayim. The Yerushalmis eat a lot of food for free. People forcing them, come and eat. Please, they're begging them, come and eat. I want to go home. I can't go home before I finish it. I have so much meat and so much fruits and so much grains. Let me finish it. I want to go home. But Bnei Yerushalayim, they're paying for it a little bit. How they're paying for it? By the regalim, the house must be open. If you buy a house in Yerushalayim, you should know that. There's a condition. What's the condition? During the regel, three times a year, all the Jewish nations are coming to Yerushalayim. Shalosh pe'ami b'shana yira'e kol zechurecha yipenei Hashem elokecha. All the men supposed to go to Yerushalayim. Where are they going to sleep? There's not enough hotels in Yerushalayim to host millions of people. Where all these people are going to sleep? מעולם לא אמר אדם, צר לי המקום שאלין בירושלים. Says the Mishnah Perkei Avot. Never a person said, it's too tight, I have no place to sleep in Yerushalayim. How come? The houses in Yerushalayim, everyone must keep his door open. As much room he can have in his house to put people to sleep, everywhere, even in the kitchen. People will sleep everywhere in the house. That's for the regel, doing the regalim, three times a year. Pesach, Shavuot, Sukkot. So that's the price. You get a hotel, but you pay, you give him a lot of meat and a lot of fruits, vegetables. Yerushalayim always had many of festive meals everywhere because of Olei Regalim and because of the Nedarim and Nedavot and Ma'asrot, Ma'asar Behema, Ma'asar Dagan, and chule. This is the mitzvah of the Torah. Where comes the Ma'asar of Kesef to do a 10% out of the money? What does it come to this story? So really, there is Tosafot. Tosafot comes on the Gemara, Masechet Ta'anit, Daf Tet. Over there, the Gemara says like this. Amar Rabbi Yohanan, Mai dichtiv aser te'aser, aser bishvil shetit'asher. You do ma'aser, if you do the ma'aser of the Torah, what the Torah commanded you to do, you will become rich. That's the meaning, the Torah doubled the words. Aser te'aser. What for the Torah doubled the words? The Torah is hinting you. If you're going to do ma'aser, you're going to become rich. The Gemara is telling a story over there. Rabbi Yohanan met the child, the new child of Resh Lakish, his friend, his havruta. Resh Lakish was in the beginning the student of Rabbi Yohanan. But he studied much Torah and he became Talmid Haver. He was almost equal to Rabbi Yohanan, questioning him, arguing with him. So many mahlokot between Rabbi Yohanan and Resh Lakish. But Resh Lakish passed away. And Rabbi Yohanan was looking after his child and he saw him one time. So he asked him, Pesuk li pesukich, what did you learn today in school? He said, I learned this pasuk, aser te aser. If you do the ma'aser, you'll become rich. And Rabbi Yohanan asked him, how can you do that? To do ma'aser in order to become rich, you're putting Hashem on a test. And the pasuk says, "Lo tenasu et Hashem elokechem." he's not allowed to test Hashem. So he told him, "Lachi amar Rabbi Yoshaya, I've learned from Rabbi Yoshaya, we're not allowed to test Hashem beside of one thing. On what? On the Ma'asir." The Navi Yeshaya says, "Haviu et kol ha-Ma'asir el Beit Ha'otzar, uvhanuni na bazot, im lo eftah lachem et arubot ha-shamayim, eftah lachem arubot ha-shamayim, v'arikuti lachem beracha ad belidai." Test me on this one, says Hashem. "Bechanuni na bazot." We're not allowed to test Hashem only on this matter, on the mitzvah of Ma'asir. What's the test? You're going to do the Ma'asir. Aviyu et kol ha-Ma'asir el Beit Ha'otzar. I will open the gates of heaven to shower blessing upon you, ad beli dai, endless blessing. The Gemara is saying, what is it beli dai? What kind of a language is this? In Hebrew, you don't say beli dai. What's beli dai? Says the Gemara, beli dai, beli milashon levalot, ad sheivlu siftotechem milomar dai, which means a person is saying, die, die. Enough. How much can I have? Ribono Shel Olam, I don't have storage. I can't have so much. Please, Ribono Shel Olam, enough. And his lips getting tired from saying the word die. Ad sheivlu siftotechem yilomar die. And Hashem keeps giving more and more and more. That's how much Berachah the Torah promised for what? For the Ma'asir. And you're allowed to test Hashem on this. Behanuni na bazot, says the Nabi. Please test me on this one. That's the pasuk over there in the Navi. And Rabbi Yohanan was telling this student, this little child, says, if you know this pasuk, you don't need Rabbi Yoshaya. Why say Achi Amar Rabbi Yoshaya? You don't need, not for you, not for your Rav. There's a pasuk, clear pasuk in the Navi. Okay. Was another argument there between Rabbi Yohanan and this child, and his mother came in and took away the child. Rabbi Yohanan looked at him like, oh, it's a sharp kid. He took. Rabbi Hanan had a very thick eyebrows. Was covering his eyes. And he had a clip made out of silver to lift the eyebrow to see. So he lifted his eyebrows to see this child, and his mother rushed to hide this baby, to take him away from Rabbi Hanan. She was scared. You know who was this baby's mother? She was the sister of Rabbi Hanan. But she knew his power. She knew her brother's power. She was afraid of this child. Says, get out of here. Run. Go hide. Don't stand here. Rabbi Yohanan's gdola do. Don't argue with Rabbi Yohanan. Start arguing with Rabbi Yohanan. Don't argue with him. She hide him. But he was a very sharp, very smart kid. The student of Rabbi Yohanan. The child of Resh Lakish. This is the Gemara. Comes to Safot over there. Asir te asir. Says to Safot. Ita besifri. That's how the Safot start. The Pasuk says, Asir te asir. Et kol tevuat zar'echa. The Torah says to do ma'aser on what? Tevuat zar'echa. The harvest comes from the seeds. En li eda tevuat zar'echa. I know that I need to do ma'aser on the grains. How do I know I should do ma'aser on parkamatia and ribit? Sh'ar revachim. Parkamatia means to do ma'aser from the business that I have. Parkamatia, that's chora, business. I do business. Or ribit. I lend money with ribit to the goy. You are allowed to lend money with ribit to the goy. And you have an income. Or v'chol sha'ar revachim, all the other incomes that I have. How do I know that I need to do ma'aser on this? We doresh the pasuk, aser te'aser et kol tevuat zarecha. Kol ba lerabot. Every time the Torah says the word kol, it comes to add, beside of what I'm telling you in specific, but there is more to it. What's more? She'ar revachim. That's the source that we see that ma'aser does not come only on the grains. Ma'aser deganecha, tiroshecha, v'itzharecha, v'chorot b'karecha, v'tzonecha. There is also ma'aser that comes from all the other incomes. There is also this derasha, a midrash tanhuma, מירקות שמעוני, פרשת ראה, ספר דברים. On this פסוק. מדרש brings a story also. מעשה באדם אחד, very rich man, he had a field, שהייתה עושה 1,000 קור בשנה. This field produced 1,000 קור every year. And this man was very particular to do the מעשה properly. He took 100 קור. קור is a measurement. It's a big measurement. He took 100 kol and he gave it maaser, 10% maaser. Before he died, he called his son. He said, listen, I'm leaving you behind a field that produced 1,000 kor every year. And the maaser is 100 kor. Be careful. He's a her to do the maasrot properly. You do the maasrot properly, you'll be rich. That was a huge amount. You'll be rich the same as I was rich. And he passed away. His son followed him the first year. He gave 100 kol maaser. Second year, I felt bad. So much maaser. 100 kol. It's a huge amount. What should I give so much? He gave just 90 kol. The next year, the field produced for him, instead of 1,000 kol, 900 kol. And he felt bad to give 90. He gave 80. He gave 80. The following year, the field produced 800. And it was going down year after year like this. He was reducing the maaser, and they said they also reduced the production. Until, by the 10th year, they said they produced for him only 100 kol. At the beginning, the maaser was 100 kol. Now he was left just with the maaser. That's what he was left with. In his town, people realized what's going on here. They saw that his field produced only 100 kol. They got up. They got dressed prop like going to a wedding. They put the very nice clothes on top of them. And they came with music to his house to visit him. And he saw the whole town come to visit him like this. They're celebrating his crush. And he asked him, why are you celebrating my crush? You know, you see, I lost so much. Why are you celebrating? He says, because the Pasuk says, "Vishit kodashav lo yihyu." If you give the kodashim, the maaser, you give it away, so you become, you're the landlord, and the Kadosh Baruch Hu is the Kohen. He's the Kohen, and he commands to give it to the poor, to give it to the Leviim, to give it to the Aniim. So, you're the landlord. But if you don't give the maaser, in the end, what's going to happen? Kodashav lo yihyu. The kodashim, the maaser that you're supposed to give, you're going to be left with that. And that means now, the positions have been changed. HaKadosh Baruch Hu now becomes the landlord, and you become the Kohen. So now we celebrate. You became Kohen today. So we're celebrating. You become a Kohen. That's the story in the Midrash. We're learning out of this Maaseh, how important it is to give Maaseh. And it's not just, if you give Maaseh, you become rich. And if you don't give Maaseh, you don't become rich, and you don't become poor. No. You give Maaseh, you become rich. If you don't give Maaseh, Chas v'Shalom, the opposite. This is the Midrash, and also, as I said, the Tosafot over there in a Masechet Anit Aftet. Among the Rishonim, we see other Rishonim that's also following the opinion of Tosafot. We have Agaot Mordechi, Bava Batra, Perek Rishon, also bring this mitzvah. There is a mitzvah to do Maaseh from all the incomes that I have. Also, Sefer Or Zeruah says the same thing. In the beginning of Sefer Or Zeruah, there is Halachot Tzedakah. Mamash in the beginning of Sefer Or Zeruah. Halachot Tzedakah, he writes first, before Kriyat Shema even, Halachot Tzedakah. And there, Siman Yud Gimel, he brings this Gemara. And on this Gemara, he says the Midrash, there is mitzvah to give 10%, not only from the Maaser, Dagan, Tirosh, V'Yitzhar, but also from all the incomes you do, you have. Should give 10%. But when we're learning Harambam, Halachot Matenot Aniyim, Perek Zayin, Halacha Hey. Harambam in this chapter, those few chapters, from Perek Vav until the end of Halachot Matenot Aniyim, Perek Yud, Harambam talks about the laws of charity, the laws of tzedakah. There is Halachot Tzedakah. And in between this halachot tzedakah, says the Rambam as follows. The beginning of this perek. Mitzvat aseh liten tzedakah le'aniye Yisrael kefi ma sheraui la'ani. Im hayta yad hanoten maseget. The obligation to give tzedakah, how much charity do I have to give? Says the Rambam. Kefi ma sheraui la'ani. Depends on the poor person. How much he needs. If he doesn't have mortgage, and he doesn't have insurance, and he doesn't have food, and he doesn't have electricity, and he doesn't have you have to give him as much as he needs, but im hayta yad anotem maseget, only if the giver is capable to give so much. This ani needs $10,000 a month. Do you have extra $10,000 to give him? Then you're supposed to give it to him. You don't have to give it so that much. Shene'emar, patoach tiftach et yadecha lo. Open your hand to him and give him. And the Torah says, ve'ehzakta bo, ger v'toshav v'chay imach. Ve'ne'emar v'chay achicha imach. Make sure he's going to live. The tzedakah you give him, it's not just a dollar to do the mitzvah, just to be yotzeh. Make sure he's going to live. That's how much tzedakah you should give him. Live properly. And the halakha says, if he's an ani ben tovim, what does it mean? He was rich before. And he was used to have luxury life. Says the Gemara, and the Rambam brings it over here. Even if he's used to ride on a horse, היה דרכו של זה עני לרכוב על הסוס ועבד רץ לפניו, והעני, he was used to it. He used to ride on a horse, and a servant running in front of him, you know, he became poor. What's our obligation? The obligation is, קונין לו סוס לרכוב עליו, ועבד לרוץ לפניו. Buy him a horse, and buy him a servant to run in front of him the way he was used to before. Why? שנאמר, די מחסורו אשר יחסר לו. It's not according to your measurements. It's according to his lifestyle. What he was used to before, that's how much we should give him. Gemara tells a story about a poor person who came to Rava and asked him for food. So Rava said, okay, I have some noodles here. And I have some cheap sandwich to give you. He said, no, I want tarnigolet mefutemet. I want a fat chicken. So that's a fat chicken. Where am I going to get you a fat chicken from? That's what you're asking for? You're asking tzedakah, and that's how you ask the tzedakah? So he asked Rava, what is you're coming from your account? Tzedakah not comes from you. Kadosh Baruch Hu gives it. You're the shaliyah, so you want to give it? Okay, if you don't want to give it, I'll find it somewhere else. Rava was wondering, what this man is talking about? He doesn't have not even a minute passed by. Somebody knocks on the door. He opens the door, his sister comes to visit him. 14 years he didn't see her. She comes to visit him, and what she's giving him as a present, Tarnigolet mefutemet. So Rava says, Min ha-shamayim, they send Tarnigolet mefutemet to this ani. He was right. Dei mahsoro, asher yahsar lo. He called him and said, here, this is your Tarnigolet mefutemet. Come and have a meal. So we see tzedakah, it's not according to my standards. It's according to the ani standards. That's the introduction of mitzvah tzedakah. And here comes the halakha that relates to ma'asrot. Says the Rambam like this. Ba'ani v'sha'al de mahsoro v'en yad anoten maseget. The ani comes and asks from you and says, I need $10,000. That's what I need. I have mortgage and I have tuition and I have electricity, and I have insurance, I need $10,000. And you don't have $10,000 to give him. How much do I have to give him? Says the Rambam, noten lo kefi asagat yado. You should give him as much as you can. What is it? How much is it? V'chama, ad homesh nechasav mitzvah min ha-muvhar. If you give him fifth from your income, that's called mitzvah min ha-muvhar. It's the best mitzvah. The source of this Rambam is the Gemara Masechet Ketubot, Daf Nun. Gemara says over there, Amar Rabbi Elah, Be'usha itkinu, ha-mevazbez, al-evazbez yoter mechomesh. Be'usha, that was times when Sanhedrin had to leave Yerushalayim and to go to different locations. So one of the locations the Sanhedrin Gedola was staying, that was Usha. It was a name of a city in Eretz Israel, up north. Usha. So the Sanhedrin went to Usha. There, when Sanhedrin was there, they made a takana. What's the takana? Amivazbez, alivazbez yoter mechomesh. If you're very generous and you give a lot of tzedakah, don't give more than 20%. 20% from your income, that's the maximum you're allowed to give. And the Gemara brings the baraita, tanya na mehachi, amivazbez, alivazbez yoter mechomesh. והיה אדם אחד, was someone who wanted to give more, and חכמים didn't give him. Who didn't give him to, who didn't allow him to give? רבי ישבב. ואמר לה, רבי ישבב wanted to give more, and רבי עקיבא hold him. And said, you don't give more than 20%. So חכמים were very strict about it, to stop a person from spending too much on charity. What's the idea behind it? חכמים didn't want the person to give everything he had, and then himself to become poor, and now he needs charity. We need to give him now. So well, what are we gaining with this? The Torah doesn't want a person to be poor and others should support him. So therefore, give 20% and keep the rest, do more business, keep growing. I'm saying that because I heard a story. Someone from Brooklyn came over crying to me that some organization kind of forced him, not forced him by a gun, but, you know, forcing can be in different ways, to donate his house to this organization. So I asked him, he was crying. He lost his house, he gave it to them. They promised him the Olam Abba and Olam Hazeh and Gan Eden and Gehinam Be'ahad. So I asked him, how many houses do you have? Do you have five houses you have? He said, no, I have only one house. That's the only house he has. So I said, how did you do that? Hachamim says, I'm Evasbez, Ali Evasbez, Yotay Mechomsh. I thought he had five houses, so he can give one house. Okay, it's a fifth. But he gave the only house he had? And do you have five times your house value in the bank? He said, yeah, his bank is zero. He has no money in the bank. The only house he had, he gave as a charity. So I told him, you did Avera. You didn't do any mitzvah, that's not a mitzvah. The Torah did not obligate you to give more than 20%. That's what the Rambam is saying over here. 20% homesh, mitzvah min ha-muvhar. Ve'ahad me'asara b'nechasav b'noni. You don't want to give 20%. So what do? How much should you give? 10%. And what's 10%? 10% says the Rambam, that's b'noni. B'noni means not a great tzaddik. A person who gives 10% is not the greatest tzaddik. And he's not rasha. He's b'noni. He's fair. He's good. He's safe. Benoni. Okay. Pachot mikan, ayin ra'a. If you give charity less than 10%, he's stingy. Ayin ra'a. He has a bad eye. They say in Arabic, tamar bu kamune. Kamtan. He can't give. His hand is closed. Can't give more. And Rambam is continuing. Ule'olam. על ימנע האדם עצמו מן הצדקה, משלישית השקל בשנה. And never you should give less than a third of a shekel. A third of a shekel. You remember מחצית השקל? How much is מחצית השקל? מחצית השקל, last year, how much you give מחצית השקל? This צדקה shouldn't be less than a third of a shekel every year. That's the minimum. Even the poor person, the most poor person in the world, must give at least one third of a shekel on a yearly basis. That's the Rambam. Now, after learning the Rambam carefully, word for word, do we see the Rambam says there is an obligation to give 10% ma'aser, the same as we're supposed to give ma'aser dagan tirosh v'itzhar? Does this sound to you like a hayuv, like an obligation, like mitzvah? It's of the Torah to give 10%? Doesn't sound like a hayu, right? First of all, it comes in Halachot Tzedakah. Yeah? Rambam is starting this perek, mitzvat aseh liten tzedakah. We have a mitzvah to give a tzedakah. And second, the Rambam says over here, ba ani v'sha'al lo de mahsoro. If a poor person came over to you and asked from you to give him a charity, then he's supposed to give. 20% mitzvah min ha-muvhar, 10% it's benoni, less than this it's ayin ra'a, don't give less than a third of a shekel. This is only if the ani came to ask. What if the ani didn't come to ask? If this is an obligation to give 10%, as the Tosafot saying, Masechet Ha'anit, Aser Te'aser, Et Kol Tivua Zarecha Lerabot Kol HaRevahim, we have mitzvah min ha-Torah to give, Ma'aser Rishon, Ma'aser Sheni, it's not depends if the Levi comes to ask. The ma'aser ani that you give from the field, it does not depend on the ger, yatom ve'almana, if they come to ask, you have to give. You don't see them, they don't come to you, you go to them. You run after them. You search for them. You must give them. The same as the teruma for the Kohen. If the Kohen doesn't come to you, you don't have to give teruma gedola. You must give. You cannot eat from the fruits if you don't do afrashat terumot ma'asot. It's called tevel. So you see that ma'aser ksafim is different. It's not the same obligation. It's not the same hayuv as the ma'asar dagan tirosh v'yitzhar. And the yuk from the end of the halakha of Rambam is stronger. What the Rambam says in the end, ולעולם הלמנע אדם עצמו משלישית השקל. What are we talking about here? Talking about someone who wants to do the mitzvah of tzedakah, but he's a kamtzan. What's the minimum he's asking? What's the minimum? You know, some people, they want to know the minimum. What's the minimum? Minimum is a third of a shekel. It's not 10%. If 10% was an obligation, mitzvah asem in the Torah, so what is it, a third of a shekel? So we're learning from this Rambam that the obligation of ma'aser, it's obligation of tzedakah. It's mitzvah tzedakah. But it's not the same as hayuv of ma'aser, tevu'ah, ma'aser dagan, tirosh v'yitzhar. It's a mahloket between Rambam and Tosafot. Also, Maharam Merotenburg, the Siman Ayin Dalet, also is a teshuva, and he writes over there, the mitzvah to give 10% from your money, from your income, it's not mitzvat aseh deoraita, and it's not mitzvat aseh derabbanan, it's minhag. Devarim amutarim, ואחרים נהגו בהם איסור. Which means it's a custom among Am Israel to give 10%. It's a good minhag, but it's not hayuv, not the Rabbanan, there is no the mitzvah the Rabbanan, and there is no mitzvah the Oraita. Also, Rav Bait Hadash, in the end of Siman Shin Amid Aleph Biore Dea, says the mitzvah of Maaser Ksafim, it's just a minhag. There's no hayuv, not the Oraita, not the Rabbanan. His son-in-law, Torei Zahav, argue with him over there. What's the source of the Torei Zahav? The opinion of Tosafot, he's quoting Tosafot, he's quoting that Midrash Tanhumai, Elkut Shimoni, says, how come you're saying it's not a hayuv? Tosafot says it's a hayuv. But the Ahronim comes, and they are answering the question of the Taz. We see from the Rambam over here, there is no hayuv, it's no hayuv gamur, it's just a search, a mitzvah tzedakah. It's a charity, it's not a hayuv, it's not a complete obligation. We see it's a big mahloket. And the halakha usually, as we do, we open Shulchan Aruch. What Shulchan Aruch is paskin. So, if you open Shulchan Aruch, Yorei Dea, Siman Resh Mem Tet, Matar. Matar, it's the rain, right? Gemara says, you know why the rain stops? In Israel, it was a drought for the last few years. Terribly drought. There's no water in Israel. Very, very bad situation. We need to pray for the rain. But the Gemara says, you know why the rain stops? Al poske tzedakah barabim ve'enam notnim. These people that they jump to give tzedakah in public, they promise to give in public. There is a magbit, and they're jumping. 505, 1,000, 10,000. Yeah, he has a light tongue. His tongue shooting numbers, but when it comes to reality, he has a heavy hand. He can't put his hand in his pocket to take the money. Yeah, his tongue is light, but his hand is heavy. So for that kind of people, the rain stops. So Siman Matar, Shulchan Aruch Yorei Dea, Maran is bringing this halakha. What Rambam is saying here, almost word for word, Maran is bringing the words of Rambam and passing halakha like this. Which means, if the poor, Ketzad hi mitzvat tzedakah, that's how Shulchan Aruch is starting. How do you do mitzvat tzedakah? If the poor person came over to you and asked him for tzedakah, you should give him 20% mitzvah min ha-muvhar, 10% benoni, less than this, ayin ra'a, and never give less than a third of a shekel. Basically what the Rambam is saying over here. It looks like Shulchan Aruch, that the obligation to give 10% out of your income, it's not obligation as mitzvah ta'aseh, but it is just a good mitzvah of mitzvah tzedakah. Nafkamina, if a person wants to give to the from the ma'aser, he wants to pay for the tuition of his children. Or he's supporting his children. They're learning Torah, they go to yeshivot, and he's supporting them in general. Can he pay that from the ma'aser? He wants to give ma'aser. He wants to be ashir also. Yeah? There is a promise to become ashir. If you give ma'aser, you become ashir. You become rich. Aser te'aser, aser b'shvil shetit asher. So he wants to be rich, but he's asking, can I give the ma'aser to my children? And that will be, I'll gain twice. I'll give it to my children, and I'll be rich also. That depends on this mahlokit. According to the Tosafot, who says it's a hiyuv by itself, so you can't give, you can't pay one hiyuv with another hiyuv. If you have one obligation to teach your son Torah, and you have another obligation to give 10% ma'aser, you can't pay one hiyuv with other hiyuv. But if the hiyuv of ma'aser, it's not a mitzvah that I have to do as a mitzvah ta'aser by itself. It's just under the umbrella of mitzvah tzedakah. Mitzvah tzedakah, the Gemara says, the pasuk, Sefer Tehilim, David HaMelech, Omer, Ashrei Shomrei Mishpat, Ose Tzedakah Bechol Et. Asks the Gemara, who's Ose Tzedakah Bechol Et? How can a person can do a charity Bechol Et? Every second you can do charity, you go to sleep, you do charity. How do you do charity when you go to sleep? When you're eating, how do you do charity? When you pray Shmona Esrei, how do you do charity? What David HaMelech is talking about? Ose Tzedakah Bechol Et. How is it possible? Says the Gemara, Ze HaMefarnes, Banav uvnotav haketanim. A person who is supporting, who's sponsoring, supporting his children while they little, he's considered Ose Tzedakah Bechol Et. And the Rishonim explains over there what age we're talking about. We're talking about above 6 years old. That's called Banav uvnotav haketanim. Less than 6 years old, he has an obligation to give them his anot. Above 6 years old, there's no hayuv. A person has have to give mezonot to his children until the age of six. More than that, he doesn't have to. And he's giving. He's supporting them. They're sleeping in his house. They're eating in his house. So even when he's sleeping, he's doing tzedakah. Why is he doing tzedakah? Because they're sleeping there too. He's feeding them. He's paying for their tuition. He's teaching them. That's called ose tzedakah bechol et. So now, if the mitzvah of ma'aser ksefim, it's the mitzvah of tzedakah, according to Rambam Shulchan Aruch, and the mitzvah to give to my children, it's also tzedakah, it's the same mitzvah. I'm not paying one hiyuv with another hiyuv. It's the same mitzvah, same hiyuv. That's a machloket among the Ahonim. Those who hold like Tosafot, they will say, no, you cannot do that. But those who hold like Rambam and Shulchan Aruch, they will say, yes, you can give, you can pay for your children's tuition from the ma'aser ksefim that you give. Truly, it's a great mitzvah to give the ma'aser. Although it's not a mitzvah by itself, but as we see, it's one of the greatest mitzvot called mitzvah tzedakah. And I would like to end with the Rambam himself on Perek Yud, the last perek of this, the tenth perek of this halachot, halachot matzenot aniyim, says the Rambam like this. How important it is to do this mitzvah of tzedakah. Hayavin anu. להיזהר במצוות צדקה יותר מכל מצוות עשה. Do you hear this Rambam? We have to be careful to do the mitzvah tzedakah more than all the other tariag, all the other ramah mitzvot עשה that we have in the Torah. We have 248 mitzvot עשה. Tefillin, Shabbat, Brit Milah, Pidyon HaBen, to fast on Yom Kippur, to eat matzah on Pesach, to take ארבעת המינים, to sit in a sukkah. Mitzvot aseh, we have to say Birkat HaMazon, to say Kriyat Shema twice a day. Ramah mitzvot, says Rambam, Hayavin, anu, leizaher, b'mitzvot tzedakah, yater mikol mitzvot aseh. More than all the other mitzvot aseh, mitzvot tzedakah, you should be more careful. Why? Sheh tzedakah siman letzaddikei zera Avraham Avinu. That's a testimony, that's an indication, that we are from the children of Avraham Avinu. Tzaddikei zara'o shel Avraham. Why? Because the Torah says about Avraham, ki da'ativ, asher etzaveh et banav uveto aharav, v'shameru derech Hashem la'asot tzedakah u'mishpat. So this is the message that Avraham Avinu gave over to his children, to do tzedakah. Also says Rambam, ואין כיסא ישראל מתכונן, ודת האמת עומדת, אלא בצדקה. שנאמר, בצדקה תכונני. Basically, the Jewish nation stand on the צדקה. And the final thing is, ואין ישראל נגאלין, אלא בזכות הצדקה. The גאולה, the final redemption. אין ישראל נגאלין, אלא, only, with the merit of this מצווה, מצוות הצדקה, שנאמר, ציון במשפט תיפדה, ושווע בצדקה. יהיה רצון שנזכה לגאולה השלמה במהרה בימינו, אמן ואמן.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.